Hi, everybody. My name is Marissa, and I have a bachelor's degree in mathematics with a minor in statistics. In today's lesson, we are going to discuss why ANOVA F-tests are used, the necessary conditions for an ANOVA F-test, and how to conduct an ANOVA F-test. ANOVA F-tests are used to determine whether or not there are statistically significant differences between more than two groups. The ANOVA F-test is an extension of the two-sample t-test. Let's imagine that we are the superintendent of a school district, and we want to investigate whether or not the salaries of the elementary school teachers in the school district differ from the middle school teachers. In this case, we can use a two-sample t-test because we only have two groups. However, let's say that we want to investigate differences between elementary school, middle school, and high school teachers. Because our number of groups is greater than two, we must use an ANOVA F-test. In order to use an ANOVA F-test, there are a few conditions that need to be met. For starters, the samples used must be independent random samples. The samples in each group also must follow a normal distribution unless the sample sizes are large enough. Typically, greater than 30 is a rule of thumb. Lastly, the largest standard deviation of each group should not be more than two times the size of the smallest standard deviation in the group. The five-step hypothesis test for ANOVA F-tests follows the same format as other hypothesis tests. The first step of the five-step hypothesis test is constructing a null and alternative hypothesis. For an ANOVA F-test, our null hypothesis assumes that all groups have equal means. We use a lowercase k to symbolize the number of groups we have. In the context of our example about the salaries of teachers, we would say the mean salaries for elementary school, middle school, and high school teachers are equal. The alternative hypothesis is only in the form of words and is some variation of not all population means are equal. In the context of our example, it would be the mean salaries for elementary school, middle school, and high school teachers are not equal. Keep in mind that in order for our alternative hypothesis to be true, only two of the means must differ. For example, elementary school and middle school teachers may have the same mean salary, but if high school teachers have a different salary than the other two groups, we would still reject the null hypothesis. ANOVA F-tests use an F-test statistic, hence the name ANOVA F-test. Variation between groups refers to how different each mean is across all groups. For example, how different salaries are between elementary school, middle school, and high school teachers. Variation within groups refers to how different means are across all members of each individual group. In our example, within groups will refer to the amounts of variation within each group individually. For example, high school teachers. Because the hands calculation of an F statistic is time-consuming, we will be utilizing Excel's single-factor ANOVA tool. Please note that most statistical software packages allow us to conduct a single-factor ANOVA test, not just Excel. We will start by clicking on the Data tab in the Excel ribbon. We will now select Data Analysis. When we do this, we will get a list of several statistical tests. We want to select ANOVA Single Factor. We now select our data and make sure that we group our data by columns, include labels, and choose the correct value of alpha, which is the probability of rejecting our null hypothesis if it were true. We also want to output our data on a new page. We now select the OK button. Our output shows us that we have an F statistic of 1.96, a p-value of 0.1971, and a critical value of 4.26. The next step in our hypothesis testing procedure is to find the p-value or the critical value. Although the p-value and the critical value are given to us on our Excel output, we can also use an F-table of critical values to find the critical values. It is called an F-table because it comes from the F-distribution. Using the table requires us knowing how to compute the numerator and denominator degrees of freedom, as well as know our alpha level. Before computing our degrees of freedom, we must select a table based on our alpha level. We will be using the alpha level of 0.05. The numerator degrees of freedom are k minus 1, where k is the number of groups. Because we have three groups, this value would be 2. The denominator degrees of freedom are n minus k, the total sample size minus the number of groups. Since we have a total of 12 observations in three groups, this value would be 12 minus 3, or 9. Using 9 as our denominator degrees of freedom and 2 as our numerator degrees of freedom, we obtain a critical value of 4.26, the same value as our Excel output. Please note that ANOVA critical values are always right-tailed and cannot be negative. Using either the p-value approach or the critical value approach, we can determine whether or not our difference in means is statistically significant at the 0.05 level of significance. Because our p-value of 0.1971 is above 0.05, we fail to reject the null hypothesis. Our test statistic, 1.96, is also below the critical value of 4.26. Because we fail to reject the null hypothesis, our conclusion will be stated as, fail to reject the null hypothesis. We cannot conclude that there is a statistically significant difference in the mean salaries of elementary school, middle school, and high school teachers. If we have rejected the null hypothesis, our conclusion would be, reject the null hypothesis. We can conclude that there is a statistically significant difference in salary for elementary school, middle school, and high school teachers. In order to correctly conduct an ANOVA F-test, there are some mistakes one should avoid. The first mistake is forgetting to check the labels in first row option in Excel. This can result in incorrect results, or Excel may not even allow computing of the results in some cases. Next, we must ensure that we are using the F table with the correct alpha level. Most critical value tables in statistics, such as T tables and Z tables, are only one table and do not have separate tables for each alpha level, so it can be difficult to remember to use the table with the correct alpha level. Lastly, we must ensure that we use k minus 1 for the numerator degrees of freedom and n minus k for the denominator degrees of freedom. If we mix up these values, we will get an incorrect critical value. Great job, everyone! Today we learned about why ANOVA F-tests are used, the necessary conditions for an ANOVA F-test, and how to conduct an ANOVA F-test. Thanks for watching, and please be sure to check out other videos about statistics lessons and applications here on Chegg. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.